We are creators of software engineers. Our lab, our art studio, our workshop is virtual. Sure, we have physical tools we use every day, keyboard, monitors, a mouse, maybe a stylus, but our true workshop is a virtual space. Looking around our virtual workshop, we do not see hammers or screwdrivers or paintbrushes nor pastels, but instead, our workshops are filled with tools made by others like us, made of software. Our tools are command line interfaces, NPM modules, build tools, transpilers. Our paintbrushes are UI frameworks like React and our favorite IDE. Our workshops are made of software. The better we know our tools, the more they do for us. It might not be important for our software tools to become an extension of ourselves, like the great masters, but we certainly do not want to let them get in our way, to hinder us. Oh, what a day when our tools fail us, when we cannot get TS-config to do what we want, when we break our hammer and we must toil just to start doing our work again. We get in the creative flow when we do not think of our tools at all. The work for us is best when we can think. Our fingers move, our IDE auto-completes some oddly named attribute with ease. We finish our render function, we tab over and see our UI auto-refresh, confirming our workshop is in tune with our wishes. Our workshop and all the tools in it are supporting us, working with us so we can focus on those interesting hard problems, those novel solutions, so that we can be creative software developers. We must remember that the output of our work, our creations, are the tools for other people. Our tools support other human beings in their creative work. As a UI engineer, I endeavor to understand the people that use the tools I write so that I can make the tool as effective to use as possible. I want people to use the software I write without thinking about the software I write. For if they are thinking and trying to figure out how to use my software, I am stealing their creative energy. All the time they spend thinking of my software is time they could have been thinking of their hard problems, their novel solutions, and their own creative work. Hi, my name is Lyle Troxell, and I have the pleasure to work at Netflix in Studio UI. I say pleasure partially because of our amazing culture, which I'll not get into now, but if you're interested, please have a listen to my We Are Netflix podcast, where I interview colleagues on the work they do at Netflix and how we do what we do. But more so, I say I have the pleasure to work at Netflix because I am part of a dedicated group of people doing our best to make an amazing workshop for filmmakers. I'm actually in a subgroup of UI focusing on animation. My colleagues and I create tools for the process of making animated movies and TV shows. In the Animation Studio Technology Group, we're building tools to connect the work of many artists together. This is called an animation pipeline. The filmmaking process in animation is complex. There are many artisans coming together to make animation. Script writers, concept artists, character props and background designers, layout artists and painters, storyboard artists, voice actors, editors, lighters, modders, riggers, animators, and many, many more. This image is from a wonderful interactive website by Illumination McGruff, a Paris-based animation studio, whom obviously worked on Despicable Me and Minions. Anyway, if you're curious about the animation pipeline concept, I strongly suggest you visit this website. In any case, people that use our software are creative and technically adept. Animation is a technical art form. Like us software engineers, many of these artists' primary work is using software to be creative. And our success in Netflix Studio is making our artists more successful. We want to make the best possible digital workshop for these artists so that their time and energy are put directly into great storytelling, beautiful, enriching worlds, and characters we fall in love with. Our job is to empower them to make wonderful shows that entertain the world. The application I'm working on currently is all in React. Actually, all of Netflix Studio is using React. In fact, we have built out a wonderful React-based design system called Hawkins, hence the Hawkins lamp image here from our show Stranger Things. And all across Studio, we share components, have a simple dedicated design system, and it's an amazing experience. In any case, if you want to read up on the Hawkins design system, take a look at Joshua Godey. He's one of the developers of it, tech blog entry about our tech blog. All the links I'm showing you today, by the way, I'll be in my repo and at the end of the slides. I'm going to demo the tool I work on using concept art from Klaus, an animated movie made by SPA Studios in Spain, directed by Sergei Pablos. It was released in 2019, so this film predates the tools I'm showing you today, and it's just for demonstration purposes. In any case, the tool I'm working on has a feature that is a grouping of images for specific parts of the show Klaus. So let's say our artist River is going to work on the background art for the post office, a key location in the film. River's been collecting images as references for the post office work. One of the first images she uploaded was this of wooden mailboxes. So because it was the first one, we made it the album art for the post office, and she hasn't changed it yet. Now, this is a UX question. Should we be auto-updating it as she adds more and more artwork for the collection? I argue no, because it is actually a navigation resource. So instead, I empower the users, the artists, to create images and use them directly. Now that other artists are going to be joining her, in fact, the art director of the show, Simon Bernacki, has uploaded this beautiful winter scene of the post office. Now that other people are joining, she wants to make a canonical image for this collection so people can find it and get used to it, but also to represent the entire collection. Now, we do already support a feature of changing the artwork. She could choose any artwork from the show. She could also save an image that was designed for this purpose and drop that file here. But I think there's a better way. You see, the goal in creating a good animation pipeline is to maximize the time the artist is creating and minimize other things like managing files. I think the simplest way for our artist to provide an image is to copy it from her drawing tools and paste it into the UI. There are two different ways of doing copy and paste, and I'm just going to talk about the classic way here. So we'll start by using state to hold an image. We'll just use image element as the way we engage with this component we'll be building. Next thing we do is we add an event listener, and in the event listener, we go ahead and grab the file itself, the blob, and create an object URL assigning it to an image. And then when the image is loaded, we can set the state of that image to then pass it to the component or so on. And don't forget when using effect to make sure you unsubscribe to anything so you don't memory leak. The second way of doing it, and the kind of new hotness, if you will, is to use navigator.clipboard. And here I'm checking to see if the clipboard exists, not because the browser doesn't support it, but just a couple things to keep in mind when developing this. This clipboard object will not exist unless you're using HTTPS. That's totally required. And also, the browser will prompt the user for access. Now, my users are onboarded to a show, and so they'll just see this once when they're using our app. So it's totally fine. So here is the accessing it. You take a look at the clipboard, you read it, and then you'll get a promise of the clipboard items. But when you read it, you'll get this prompt. And you can't stylize this prompt. It's just whatever the browser is going to render. Here's Chrome rendering it. If they allow it, you'll notice that there is a little button up in the right. The user can click and change preferences. So if you do ever see that, it means the site you're on is looking at the clipboard. All right, so we take a look at the items. We filter them for image JPEG. I was testing this out in a Mac, and so image PNG is the type of clipboard binary that I get. In any case, then you do have to do a get type. This get type interface is a few different gets on the clipboard item. But get type will actually type it, and you'll produce a blob for an image PNG. And then we do the same thing, right? We create an object URL. We assign it to an image source. When the image source loads, we set the image. So now, someone like River, an expert in digital art, can go ahead and open a piece of artwork that she wants to use to make a composite image. I'm doing Command-Control-Shift-4 in macOS to get a copy area. Now, River is an expert in Photoshop, so she's going to use Photoshop to composite her image. Again, Command-Control-Shift-4. Copying the image she wants. Now, instead of actually putting in this app, let's go ahead and use the app that I made for this conference talk and paste it in. And there it is, the artwork exactly as River wanted. Of course, she could have spent more time, whatever. The source code for everything I've done and also the links are all available at this repo. All the shows that I'm talking about and the images and stuff are all available. Feel free to grab it, use it, give me pull requests, whatever you'd like. I do have a little bit of imposter syndrome, I have to say. So let me know, but be kind if I have any problems in it. Now that I've made this paste message component, it's ready to be dropped into any React app. So I can drop it into the app I work on in animation. And, you know, I'll integrate it with our React design system, Hawkins, and then make it available to the rest of my colleagues across Netflix Studio. As a React component, this little feature of receiving a paste events as a blob, as an image, this little tool has been added to the software workshop of Netflix Studio. allowing us to make better software in our workshop for our artists to use. Thank you so much for joining me today, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the conference.